Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum and a very good day to you all. In this video, I'm going to review my own book, which is titled 10 Research Topics Related to Ordnance Disposal. Okay. Myself is Ahmad Umayzi bin Helmi. I'm the co-founder and creator of Software Thesis, which is the software that I created with my brother. This software can help you to write thesis because it's contract. It will extract contents from your journal collection and using that content with artificial intelligence like ChatGPT, you can write the thesis with ease. Okay, using my method, I can identify 10 research topics related to ordnance disposal. Okay, these topics are a combination from 28 journals. The link of my book, I will put in the comment section in the video. Okay, so introduction to ordnance disposal research. Okay, what is ordnance disposal? Okay, it is popular by it's a job by police and also the military. Whenever there are wars, World War I, World War II, also. Like for example, the latest one is Russia-Ukraine war, and all the previous war, they have ordnance, they have unexploded explosive. Okay, in the ground, in the forest, in the sea, in the marine environment, and everything, this unexploded explosive will be a threat, everlasting threat, unless someone from the ordnance disposal team, they come and they dispose the explosion, because it can be active at any time. Somebody who are unfortunately unlucky, they may step on that unexploded ordnance, and then we become harm to them. Okay, we become harm to them, maybe result in death and everything. Okay, so some of the topics related to ordnance disposal are efficacy and environmental impact, low order deflagration and versus high order detonation. Okay, high order detonation effectively at completely neutralizing USO, but produce significant acoustic disturbances and environmental contamination because it is too large. And then of course, all these environmental factor will be all the ordnance will be destroyed. But it will cause environmental impact like acoustic, like so the sound is very very powerful and everything may be harmful to everyone. Okay, so low order deflagration, less harmful alternative, but with reduced acoustic and chemical impact, but leave residual hazard because maybe some of the explosion, some of the ordnance is not totally being disposed. They may have some residues. Okay, so environmental trade-off, balancing the need of for safety with the goal of minimizing environmental harm, because suppose there is a war going on, and after how many years, 10 years, 20 years, that field, okay, will become agricultural land, or they will become construction built up on it. And when they are doing digging, construction, they find the unexploded ordnance, okay? So they have to dispose it. They call the police, they call the military, they have to dispose it. Okay, this is the thing that because the surrounding have civilization, they have the houses, they have the farms and everything. So what will happen to them, to that environment? Okay, so detecting explosive residue with high resolution mass spectrometry. Okay, high resolution mass spectrometry offers great sensitivity and accuracy in detecting thermally unstable explosive residue. Okay, the challenges in detection and standard are the standardization and cross-contamination, significant challenges, especially in complex environmental metric. Okay, detection technology are crucial for assessing contamination levels and ensuring safe disposal practice because because the environment is so contaminated with other things, and then the element of explosion is only one part of it. Okay, but there are agricultural lands, there are many things lah. Okay, so how to detect it? This is a very main challenges because we have to identify this element have more element of explosion and everything. Maybe it is a threat, maybe it is not a threat, but this is the thing that we have to counter lah. Yeah. Okay, comparative analysis, high order versus low order detonation technique. Okay, high order detonation creates significant acoustic disturbances and environmental contamination. Well studied, but environmentally costly because it may damage all the surrounding. Low order detonation, lower acoustic impact, reduce environmental damage, but question remains on complete USO neutralization. Maybe if we not complete, thoroughly lah. Okay, then maybe have residues. So you have to do it several times. Okay, highlight gap in literature review comparing this method under control condition, emphasizing the need for more research. Okay, environmental impacts on ordnance disposal. So chemical contamination, the risk of toxic chemicals like TNT during disposal operation leading to long-term ecological damage. Okay, especially in marine environment lah. Let's say that unexploded ordnance, someone find it in the sea, in the river. So when you dispose it, maybe the fishes will be died, everything acoustic impact. The coral reef with that and everything. So this is the impact lah. High levels of underwater noise causing stress and potential harm to marine organism, marine ecosystem effect, the impact of benthic communities and broader marine ecosystem due to sediment disturbance and contamination. Okay, cotton fabric's role in explosive residue transfer. Okay, cotton fabric exhibits specific properties that influence the transfer and detection of explosive residue. Challenges detection challenges material interaction and lead to variability in residue detection, affecting forensic and disposal process. Understanding the material effect is critical for improving accuracy in explosive residue analysis and safety protocol. This is when, let's say, someone a civilian find that residue, okay, unknowingly that chemical residue when he touched at that time he did not know it is an chemically explosive, that all these chemical come to his clothes, right? And then he go elsewhere and everything. So all the chemical residue is with him. Okay, so is it effect for him or not? Maybe have chemical thing, it has effect because it is toxic and everything. Maybe, yeah, this is why the research is for lah. Okay, so in situ detection, ammunition detection technology, the new detection gaps address. Okay, new technologies are closing the gap in in-situ detection, allowing for more accurate identification of USO. Advancements include new sensor technology, imaging methods for detecting buried and submerged ordnance, and operational benefits, enhanced detection capabilities to improve safety and efficiency in ordnance disposal operation. Because the unexploded ordnance is inside the ground. Okay, on the surface you do not know. When you digging it 1 meter in the ground, you will find it. Okay, unexpectedly you will find it using forklift, backhoe and everything. If you find in the ground, okay, how to detect on the ground? This is the thing that people you can do research on it. Okay, cross contamination, explosive residue transfer. Okay, explosive residue transfer can lead to cross contamination, complicating detection and forensic analysis. Mitigation technique, implementing rigorous protocol to prevent cross contamination, and ensure accurate detection result and forensic and operational impact. Cross contamination can affect the reliability of forensic evidence and operational safety in ordnance disposal. Okay, this is about cross contamination in previous topic on cross contamination. Okay, risk assessment in management of USO. Okay, so comprehensive risk assessment, identifying and evaluating the various risks associated with unexploded ordnance. Management strategy, so they're implementing an effective strategies to mitigate identified risks and ensuring safety and environmental protection. System thinking, utilizing a holistic approach to understand an interconnection between different risks and cumulative impact. Okay, shortwave dynamics and mitigation in ordnance disposal. Okay, shortwave propagation, exploring how shortwave travel to different environment affecting both USO and surrounding ecosystem. Okay, because whenever explosion happen, you can feel the vibration. Okay, you can bring the vibration coming up in on you. Okay, this vibration will come to you as a wave. It will hit your body and you can feel the wave. In normal environment, you cannot feel it, but when you are dealing with explosion, you can feel the wave, feel coming to you. Okay, So this is the shockwave. Okay, so we can cause significant environmental damage, particularly to marine life and seabed structure. Mitigation strategy: how to mitigate the shockwave so that it will be reduced. Okay, reduce the environmental impact lah. Okay, polycarbonate. Okay, the last topic is polycarbonate plastic and explosive residue extraction. Okay, polycarbonate plastic surface affect how explosive residue adhere to air transfer, impacting detection accuracy. Okay, material interaction complicate forensic analysis, necessitating a tailored approach for different material. Operational consideration, understanding the properties of polycarbonate plastic can improve safety protocol and residue detection method. Okay, that's all the research topic that I have covered in my book. Okay, for those who from military and police who are in ordnance disposal, you can buy my book. You can get my book in from Amazon, or you can contact me. Okay, that's all for the book review today. Inshallah, we meet in other videos. Okay, thank you very much.